MrExcel Podcast is sponsored by MrExcel. Learn Excel from MrExcel Podcast, episode 1474, date next to yes. Today's question sent in on YouTube, Superbeast 326 says, anytime I enter the word yes, I want the cell to the right of it to show the date that that yes was entered. And as I think about this, he probably has a column. Right? There's probably a column that he's going to be entering that in, because I can't imagine he would just want it to work everywhere. So I'm going to remember here that we want this to work if the yes is in column D, which is the fourth column. All right, so we're going to switch over to VBA with Alt F11. In the Project Explorer, we're going to find the worksheet. So I'm right here on sheet one, double click, left drop down, choose worksheet, right drop down. We're going to choose every time they change the worksheet. I'm guessing that he's going to be entering the word yes. It's not going to be as a result of a formula. If it was the result of a formula, we would use calculate, as we did, I think, last Thursday. So target is a variable, an object variable, that is the cell that was just changed. So if target.value is equal to 4, I'm sorry, if target.column is equal to 4, then, in other words, that's saying if the cell they just changed is in column D, A, B, C, D, then if target.value is equal to yes, now are they entering uppercase, lowercase? I don't know. So let's convert whatever they entered to lowercase, not in the cell, but just here in VBA. So in the spreadsheet, we would use lower. In VBA, they use L case for lower. All right, if all of that is true, then we want to go to the cell to the right and enter the current date. We're not going to actually go to that cell. We're just going to enter the date in that cell to the right. So target, that's a variable again, dot offset, zero rows, down, one column over, dot value is equal to date. End if, and then end if. Now this little bit of code is called an event handler macro. Every time someone changes the worksheet, it's going to go do all of this. Now, this is actually going to run a little bit slow because when we change the worksheet to put the date in, it's going to run the code a second time. So let's just say right here, application.enableEvents is equal to false, and then after we enter the date, copy that and paste. This just prevents the macro from running twice every single time that someone changes a cell. All right, so we come out here to column F, we enter something, nothing happens. Enter yes out in column F, nothing happens. In column D, enter no, nothing happens. Enter yes in column D, and we get the date. Very, very sweet trick. Works with uppercase, works with upper and lowercase, works with any way you want to enter yes. It's going to give you that date. It'll work anywhere in column D. Page down all the way down here, enter yes, and there's our date. Look how fast it runs. You can't even see the screen flash. It's just like magic. Just like magic. So hey, I want to thank Superbeast for sending that question in. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.